Welcome to Ocrop's YouTube channel, your world for information. Topic for now is the legendary cricketers of Australia. Before we enter the topic, a quick reminder and request to subscribe to my channel if you already haven't. Please hit the bell button so that you can receive the notifications for my future videos as well. If I have to talk about all the great Australian cricketers, at least I need to make 5 or 6 videos only about that. Aussies have always been world beaters and champions. Words are few to explain the domination of Australians in the world cricket in the recent past. Their consistent performance got them 5 World Cup titles. Who could deny their domination in the longer format of the game, the Test cricket, especially the Ashes? It is a fact that no team played as consistently as Australia did, both in the shorter as well as the longer version of the game. The champion side has produced some world-class batsmen, bowlers, fielders, and has never been a dearth of talent when it comes to cricket in Australia. They have always played like a champion. Their psychological game has always applied the pressure on the opponent teams, and they themselves know how to handle the pressure. Too often have we seen a young team of Australian cricketers coming together, and soon the team is rebuilt to form a champion side. Their mental toughness and their winning habit makes the cricket down under a bad Australian sledge, but they are definitely a champion side. Doesn't matter what they do. Steve Smith. Smith's entry into the national side was as a leg spinner, and he turned into a batting wonder in all the forms of the game. This is what mental conditioning could do to someone like Smith. He did well as a captain too, but it ended in a bad note. Mike Hussey. This cricket's mental strength made him to be more consistent, and he turned out to be a pillar for the Australian batting side when he was around. Mark Taylor. Mark played a vital role as a leader in the Aussie team building after he took the reins from Alan Border. Mark was a great test batsman too. The Watt twins, Steve and Mark. The Sydney twins went on to become the most successful and powerful twin cricketers. While the Iceman Steve was popular for his leadership and all-round abilities, his twin brother Mark was an elegant batsman. These two dominated the world cricket for more than a decade. Mitchell Clarke. The pup was a dominant middle-order batsman and a left-arm orthodox spinner. He was a World Cup winning captain, and how often we have seen the match winning knocks from him. However, his Ashes losses were hurting. Matthew Iden, the prolific opener, impressed the world with his batting and his attitude in his reappearance. He was a late bloomer, alright, but along with Gilly, he has destroyed a lot of bowling attacks. Adam Gilchrist. Gilly was a batsman, wicketkeeper, and a match winner. The belligerent late order batsman in Test has devastated many bowling attacks as an opener in the shorter format as well. Dennis Lilly. Lilly was a fearsome and lively fast bowler with an extra special attitude. His competitiveness was always a tough competitor, and he gave always his best. Lilly was a treat to watch. Alan Border. AB rebuilt the Aussie team and the World Cup winning captain in 1987. The classy left-hander was a run machine and a match winner too. The punter, Ricky Ponting. The punter was a prolific scorer and an aggressive leader. How often he has won matches with his bat. His fielding skills were exceptional too. Keith Miller. Keith Miller is arguably the best cricketing all-rounder Australia has ever produced. Greg Chappell. The graceful and elegant Greg was a competitor and would probably be the greatest batsman of his time. His controversial role as the coach of Indian cricket side is forgettable. Glenn McGrath. McGrath is synonymous with accuracy and consistency. If it is line and length, it is only McGrath. For almost a decade and a half, he was ruling the world cricket's medium fast bowling. Shane Warne. Warne, the magician, was a leg spinning wizard. His competitive attitude and mental toughness were always a great combination. how often have you seen him come back and get wickets after getting beaten by the batsman? Who else could have bowled the ball of the century? Only one he could. Sir Donald Bradman. The dawn of the cricketing world is undoubtedly the greatest batsman of all the time. What could Bodyland do to the invincible? Sir Don is great by any stretch of imagination. There is no player who could get near Sir Don. Salute to Sir Don. I know I have missed a few players here, and I could name a few instantly. Brett Lee, Rodney Marsh, Ian Healy, there could be many more. Mention the player whom you prefer as a legendary Australian cricketer, and you could also add the reason why you think him to be a legend. I hope you enjoyed the account on the legendary Australian cricketers. Hope to see you with more such videos in the future. Thanks for watching. Good day. Bye-bye.